is this? Tabletop Island. Let's see what this is all about.
Welcome to Tabletop Island. I'm Bernardo, your host, and today we're going to be taking a look at the board game Footloose. This is by Funko Games and some of my favorite designers over at Prospero Hall. Oh man, this is a cool one. It's just such a funny theme, and if you've seen the movie and you like the movie, you might want to stay tuned for this one because it's a good one. But let's first take a look at the components. So first you have these really standard playing cards. They have really amazing art on them, mind you. I just absolutely love the 80s style and the kind of retro color. Obviously, with the channel being kind of the retro VHS style, this fit perfectly, especially when it came down to filming it. You have these really nice player boards, which are two dual-sided because there's six rounds. Just absolute amazing color scheme here. It follows through with the tokens. You have kind of the musical note tokens, which the one note's for 1 point, the others is 3 points. So you can kind of mix and match to kind of minimize your stack of tokens. You also have a really nice kind of prom globe and the kind of tractor token piece. All really nice, thick quality, as to be expected with cardboard and board games. I don't think I've ever really had a problem with that. And then finally, you have these really hilariously awesome kind of shoes, which can go on your fingers, which they don't really advertise it as that's what you're supposed to do, but come on, they knew we were gonna do that. That's absolutely hilarious. Now, putting it on your fingers is not a part of the game, so if that's what you thought it was going to be, like I did, they got me. But I was still interested because I was a big fan of the movie. And again, these designers, I've always been on the lookout, and I've gotten everything they've gotten thus far. They haven't disappointed me yet, so I immediately dove into it, and I am so glad I did. Now, while, again, you don't really wear them on your fingers, they are more like player pawns. So if you can play with up to 8 players. So each of you would only get 1 foot, and as you move through each of the phases, you move the foot onto that space on your player board. If you end up playing with less than four or less players, then you can get 2 of them and you can play with them because they're a lot of fun. I recommend it. But the gameplay itself, it's a pressure luck game. So the goal is, for each round, it displays 3 of the kind of points to where you can stop. So you must at least get the kind of minimal number that it shows there. And then the maximum, which is the red number, is the highest you can go. If you go past it, you bust. So you want to make sure that you draw cards and keep revealing to get as close to that high number as possible, because you're going to get points dependent on the number that you get to. Unless you go over. Or there's another way to go over, or bust, I should say, by getting 2 of the kind of no dancing cards, which are, obviously, if you're familiar with the movie, dancing's illegal and everybody wants to get their foot loose. That was a really bad way to describe it. I am so ashamed of myself. Now, once you stop, you collect points for the number that you get to, and then you get to choose the highest point card in your hand, put it aside, because you'll get to that point when you get to prom, which will be very crucial. Trust me, Those points matter. And then if for whatever reason you bust, then you take the lowest. But there's still hope for you yet. Even if you bust, there are still cards that are lower numbers on them, but also have either a dual number, which is the split card, or it will have a card that's worth 1 point, but it says in the kind of text for the card that it's worth 5 points during prom, which is the highest level of points you can get for the game. So be on the lookout for those cards. They are a big help. And then as you kind of progress, you get to the first kind of stage, which is the bottom of the first side, which is the tractor chicken. Hilarious, I know. And what you're doing is you're drawing one card at a time, not revealing it to your opponent, and going around kind of like chicken. Do you want to keep drawing cards? Okay, I'm going to stop before I bust. The card effect text does not matter in this round, but you still don't want to go over that bust number. And the no dancing cards will not get you over. Then you continue the normal rounds up until you get to prom. What it ends up doing is it ends up having 4 cards face down by the end of the game. Those 4 cards are the cards that you use during prom. You draw an extra card and then prom begins. You get to put 1 card face down in front of you, and everyone does that. When everyone has one face down, you reveal at the same time. The person who has the highest point count wins that round, puts that face down in front of them. The player who ends up tying, if there is a tie, they both keep it face up. And you do that for 2 rounds after the first, and then the final one you reveal 2 cards face, you reveal your last 2 cards, and then the player who has the sum that's highest wins that round. And man, this is super crucial because you get 6 points, which I know doesn't sound like a lot compared to a lot of point gathering games, but this is a good chunk of the game. Now, I have seen it to where you don't win off of just getting that, so don't be too discouraged if you don't win prom, but it's definitely kind of important to at least try to kind of collect the highest value cards, and being on the lookout for the cards that have the 1 value but are worth 5 during prom, because those can save your butt in this game, trust me. And then at the end of the game, you add up your points. Whoever has the most points wins. It's a really fast paced game, easy to teach, fun for the whole family. And honestly, at first I thought maybe this might overstay its welcome when I saw how many rounds there were, but when I realized how fast it was, it's easy to teach. I'm a big fan of their rule books with kind of games that Prosper Horror are attached to. I'm going to be doing a video talking about rule books. I would absolutely love to interview whoever's been doing theirs because they are killing it. I'm not the greatest with rule books, so it being kind of really well written is super important and dumbed down for me. I can see this one coming out at a certain special time, and the fact that it plays up to 8 players is super important for me. I don't have a lot of games that can do that, so that is kind of a factor that can lean me towards playing it more. Now, again, I will probably appreciate it, or you guys would probably appreciate it more if you enjoy the movie and you love the theme, but you don't have to know anything about the movie to enjoy the game. It's just a simple pressure luck game with a really fun theme and amazing color scheme. And that's it. Honestly, it's really cheap, a good price point. I'll leave it in the link in the description so you can take a look for your Amazon Prime needs. But honestly, that's it for you. If you are interested in notifications, there is a bell up there somewhere. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I do appreciate any feedback. I'm trying to make these videos more and more outrageous, and with your guys' help, I have been doing so. Monday, regular board game reviews. Wednesday, weekly update /talks. And then on Fridays, my vintage board game reviews. That is all I have for you guys today. I'll see you guys next time.